My name is Sharon Hettinger, and I'm the director of the Bell Choir here at Emmanuel Lutheran Church. We're very pleased to see you this afternoon, and I know you're in for a real treat. One thing in advance, I don't want your cell phone bell ringing to interfere with their bell ringing, so would you please make certain that your phone is silenced, and then we will welcome the Bell Choir, Lawrence Community Handel Choir.
Thank you. Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for coming out for our concert this afternoon. The piece that you just heard, obviously, included selections from Phantom of the Opera. Lots of movement going on, and you will see and hear that throughout the concert this afternoon. This spring, we have focused on all secular music, something very different for us. That's why you're not hearing hymn tunes, Christmas carols, etc. Zhege is our next piece. It's pronounced Z-H-E-G. It's a French word, and it was a standard dance movement from about 1650 to 1750, a little before any of our times. Jason Krug's Zhege uses 3 to 6 octaves of bells and 3 to 6 octaves of chimes, with several different bell techniques, mallets, marks, mark lifts, and shakes. If you are not a bell ringer and you don't know any of those terms, ask us after the concert and we'll be happy to tell you and show you what those mean. Play Phantom of the Opera there, nor could we play several of these other things. So we did add in Hymn to Joy, which you will hear now with Dr. Matt Gender.
Woo!
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 On piano. Hymn to Joy.
Telling you right now. So it caused such distress.
trust in him of women, that he would marry a young girl from the kingdom, and the very next morning, because he knew she would cheat on him, he would have her beheaded. So this went on for quite some time until they were running out of young women in the kingdom. And so this young woman named Scheherazade, who was a very clever young woman, said, I think I can do this. And then she actually went to save her sister, because she knew her sister was the next in line. So it was like, you know, like that Hunger Games, you know, I volunteer. So anyway, she went to the Sultan. And so the night after they were married, she began a story. And she told a series of stories, 1,001 stories. And these are the stories that we know as of the Arabian Nights. There's the story of Sinbad the Sailor. And of course, the one that's out in the popular movie right now, Aladdin. That's a big one right now. Anyway, she would tell these stories at night. And just before midnight, before it was time for her to be beheaded, she would get to the very most exciting climax of the story, and she would say, oh, sorry, can't tell you the rest of the story. I guess it's time for me to be beheaded. And the Sultan would say, oh, no, I want to hear the rest of the story. And so the next night, she would start a new story. And every night, this went on for 1,001 nights. Well, as you've probably guessed, he fell in love with her. And of course, she became the Sultaness, and she lived for many, many years. And his trust in women was restored thanks to Scheherazade. So, Scheherazade is portrayed in this particular arrangement. You'll hear this sort of lilting triplet melody, da 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 da, and that's her telling the story. The piece opens with these big, kind of majestic chords, and that's the Sultan. And then each section you're going to hear is one of the stories that she tells. And then at the end, she finishes up her stories, and then, well, I guess you'll just have to decide, did she live? Or did she die? Because it tells at the end of the piece. This is Scheherazade by Rimsky-Korsakov, 1880.
Thank you. Thank you.
comedian. As well as serving as a part-time conductor, I'm also CFO for this organization. Lawrence Up Handbell Choir is a nonprofit 501c company. We rely completely on donations for purchase of music, purchase of equipment, and we have next season, I'm not going to tell you about it now, but next season when you come to our opening concert, we're going to start a new thing. We're going to start fundraising for something that we've really, really wanted for a long, long time. But you can help us get a head start on that today. Back in the back, there are some envelopes. If you would like to make a small donation at the end of the concert, if you thought the music you heard today was well worth it, we would very much appreciate it and help us out. And of course, it is tax deductible. So thank you if you can do that for us.
Well, I'll give you a little preview of what we're going to be looking towards. This group does not own any of these bells nor the chimes. Central United Methodist Church on Mass Street owns almost all of our equipment, almost all the bells and chimes. They own 5 octaves of Malmark bells and 4 octaves of chimes. And so through the generosity of First Presbyterian Church, where I happen to be the bell director, we have borrowed the bottom of the 5th and the 6th octave of chimes, the great big ones which you will hear on the last piece. So just keep that in mind. That's Georgia on My Mind is a 1930 song written by Hoagie Carmichael and Stuart Gorrell, and it was first recorded that year. It has often been associated with Ray Charles, who was a native of the state of Georgia and who recorded it for his 1960 album, The Genius Hits the Road. Art Morris gives us his own handbell arrangement of this classic, Georgia on My Mind.
Thank you.
not only have great ringers, we have two people in this group who have composed for us this year. The first one is Karen Puckett. You all know her. The second one is Matt Gender. Matt has just finished his doctoral degree in organ performance at KU.
Yay.
Please enjoy his composition, Swing Dance.
So Swing Dances is actually a collection of three different jazz-inspired dances for the handbells. I wanted to compose something with a little bit of a jazz influence for this group. So this is the result. Swing Dances, you'll hear the transition between each of the different sections. They're all little tiny dances with a pretty large gospel-style ending. So this is Swing Dances for handbells.
Thank you.
pretty much where you ring. I have a friend who has rung AB5 since 1980-something. But we wanted a little bit of variety, we wanted a little bit more of a challenge, so we do move around. Sometimes it looks like chaos, but it's not. Everyone knows where they're going, hopefully. Chris Malachi Rhythms underscore Jason Krug's energetic setting of the well-known traditional American tune, When Johnny Comes Marching Home. The song was originally credited to Patrick Sarsfield Gilmore, who was an 1848 Irish immigrant to Boston, whom John Philip Sousa called the father of the American band. So that was high praise. This arrangement travels through a variety of moods and keys while maintaining that same sense of urgency and excitement throughout. When Johnny Comes Marching Home. Closely on this piece.